administration of the KG6 Ice Blast.
This is Dan, the Mole Man Smith.
All right. What are you going to do? There's two trigger. This up and then in.
Up and in.
Up and in. Okay. So what you're going to do is put this over your shoulder, like Mr. Freeman. And what you're going to do is you're going to start here, and you're going to do like so.
Start all the way across.
Okay? Like this. You're going to go all the way across. Now I'm going to spin it. Then you're going to do it like this and like this. And get a before picture. Come get a before picture. You would, Tracy. And then before video. You can see the circuit card there. We're going to clean everything as we go through it.
Looks pretty dirty.
All right. So, over your shoulder.
All right.
That's the reason that's on, because this is very cold and don't stick your handle stick.
And don't point that at anybody, Daniel.
I don't need to remember. Up. With the switch and then
toward
you.
Okay.
You good? Go for it. You'll feel it when it's there. Amazing.
Ooh,
that machine is
shiny
without hurting any of the components inside. You want to stay away from the speaker, you know, the camera speaker.
You want to stay away from the trigger, the cable is very hard, but they're dropping away from it. But if you want to get even more specific with this, if you smoke one that we have inside, what we're trying to do here is get the hydrocarbons from whatever the fire or whatever the disaster was out of the unit, so when the unit is energized again, it doesn't create problems for the solder points and it doesn't smell in the house. But the idea is we're trying to save the life of it. And if the hydrocarbons and the things that are in the air from the fire don't get removed from the circuit card, 2-3 months later and so forth, this cold solder point will turn into open. We just got a lesson about restoration in a different form other than dry ice blasting, working on electronics. So stay tuned. Dan the Mole Man Smith.
There you go.